A new exhibit that looks back at the history of legendary kids' TV shows is now open to all at the Myseum.
And that's where we find our G on Lee this morning. It kind of gives you that retro vibes and sort of a throwback feel, doesn't it, G?
Oh my goodness, I am reliving my childhood right now. Like, take a look at some of these incredible props and a look back at some of the incredible shows from the 1950s all the way through to the 1990s. This is Myseum of Toronto. And when you come back, when you come here, you're gonna get a look at, you know, some of the incredible programming that took place over the decades. Joining me now is Ed Conroy, co-curator of this incredible museum. Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, first of all, we need to point out, I love the Electric Circus t-shirt and this pin.
Yes, that was the old CTV CFTO logo, Agent Court Studios, where they filmed Uncle Bobby back in the day.
Amazing. So tell me a little bit more of Myseum of Toronto.
Sure. So the Myseum of Toronto, located at 401 Richmond, we're doing this wonderful exhibit till the end of August. It's focusing on the history of Toronto kids shows from the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. There was a hotbed of activity, really, in Toronto in those decades of shows like Mr. Dressup and Friendly Giant and Degrassi.
So we've got some of the puppets.
Casey
there.
And Finnegan over here.
We even have the tickle trunk.
We have a tickle trunk here for any kids that might want to do some costume play and, you know, rewind to those innocent days of staying home sick and watching Mr. Dressup.
Yeah, and the whole museum is very interactive. Let's take a little tour. So
sure.
This is a Mr. Dressup, but then you also have polka dot.
Of course, we had to welcome you in through the polka dot door. These shows were so important to us growing up. It was before the internet, there was no TikTok, and really you were anchored to the television. So I think we've basically got all of the biggest shows that were made in Toronto, and it was such an incredible time. And really, my company, Retrontario, focuses on collecting all of this footage. So in addition to the props, we've got television screens that are showing all this classic footage, too.
Amazing. And some of those shows, obviously, like Degrassi and YTV The Zone. Thank you so much, Ed. And speaking of YTV, look who's here.
Oh, it's... Phil, you're so good looking. Oh.
It's PJ Freshfield.
How are you?
I'm good. It has been a long time. You
it's
have not
time.
Changed.
Really?
Yes.
You don't see all the salt and pepper.
I
and
love it.
I'm a bit, you know.
So what do you think of Myseum of Toronto and just highlighting all these incredible shows?
I love it. I love it. You know, I was a part of it. I kind of made the 42-year cutoff. you know what I mean? But Toronto's important to me. I grew up here. A lot of great television was made here. And I don't know. Like, what do I say? Look at this, my face. I'm so embarrassed. But, you know. Yeah, proud to be a part of all
for
of this.
For sure. You were an OG. You know, there weren't that many Asian people on TV at that time.
Yeah, that's true. But, you know, YTV was great. We had everybody representing. We had African-American, Caucasian, me. but, yeah, it was an early version of it. But I got to tell you, I didn't even think about it. It wasn't in my brain. But I look back at it, how important that was.
For sure. All right, so if you want to check out Myseum of Toronto, it runs through till August 19th. For more information, just go to museumoftoronto.com. It's free.
But hey, does this look familiar to you, Nick? This is from The Friendly Giant. It was such a hit show for kids, and that's what this is all about, Myseum of Toronto. It's free. It runs through until August 19th. You're going to see a look back at some of the incredible children's programs that took place that were developed right here. And look who's here, PJ Fresh Phil from YTV. You know, back then, you were just a baby.
I was a kid. I was 20 years old, and it was my first real job. You know, and it was a family. We didn't know what we were doing at the time. The whole essence of what I was doing was because the CRTC said, you know, you could have your kids' network, but you could only show this amount of commercials to them. And we had American shows which ran long for commercials, and they had to fill the time. And it was just put these guys on to fill the exact time we need. And you know, we did crafts, we read birthdays, but in essence, what ended up happening was we were babysitters, we were older brothers and sisters, and we sort of really set the tone of like, if I didn't realize it at the time, but if I said, this is cool, it would resonate. It would be pebbles in a pond. And
yeah, many kids grew up with you. I loved watching you. It was so unique and different at that time to have program jockeys. You know what I mean?
Right.
Right? And people are wondering now, what are you up to these days?
I'm back in Canada. You know, same thing. I'm auditioning. I've been on a few commercials.
Nice.
I started wrestling last year. I'm 51 years old. And listen, I keep doing new. I'm always looking for another way to challenge myself and learn. And I don't care if it's my hobbies and working on guitars or. But at one point after YTV, I went to Los Angeles, lived there for 8 years, and I toured with a goth band. I was a celebrity stylist. I had a bit of a fashion line. I was taking hip hop dance classes from Justin Timberlake's choreographer.
Oh my goodness, so super
busy. It was. My life kind of. I don't know. After doing something for 11 years, I had to keep going and going and going.
Well, listen, if you want to see some of the incredible stuff that Phil did or the incredible programs from 1950s all the way through to the 1990s, you got to come to Myseum of Toronto. For information, myseumoftoronto.com.
We are live here at Myseum of Toronto. It's a free exhibit running through till August 19th, and it's looking back at all the incredible children's shows from the 1950s to the 1990s. And what I love is you can come here, get into interactive, walk down memory lane, make a puppet. This is Rascal the raccoon from Roncesvalles with the CP24 mic. How cool is that? I'm going to join Heidi Reitmeier now. She's a co-curator for this incredible museum. Good morning.
Hi, nice to meet you.
So tell me a little bit more of the purpose and the reason for doing Myseum of Toronto.
Well, Myseum of Toronto is the first city museum. Toronto doesn't have a city museum, unlike New York, LA, lots of large cities. So we've gathered together, we've been in existence about 6 years, and we tell the story, the history of Toronto. So we look at the past, the present, and thinking about our future.
And this one really focuses on TV shows, specifically children's programming.
Toronto was a hotbed of creativity for about 40 years. So this show really looks at all the incredible work that people did who were living and working here at that time.
And I love that kids and parents can go through all this, walk down memory lane. But there were so many incredible shows like The Friendly Giant, Today's Special. These are programs I grew up on.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely grew up. My favorite is Mr. Dressup. He was, and Polka Dot Door were two of my favorite. And Elmore the Safety Elephant, I remember being really, really conscientious when I was crossing the streets. You're right about the puppets. We actually made the exhibition both so you can passively watch things for hours, but we invite people to come down with any age of all ages and make a puppet if they'd like, or play with a puppet and audition for our channels.
Amazing. Thank you so much for that, Heidi. So again, this exhibit runs through till August 19th. It is free. For information, just go to myseumoftoronto.com. And speaking of Mr. Dressup, look who's here. It's Mark the Repairman from Mr. Dressup.
Hey. Hey, dum diddly dum. I hate dum diddly dum.
Are you always this cheery in the morning and singing?
Go to bed happy, wake up happy. Yes, indeed.
How does it feel to walk into this museum and see the props and everything? Yes.
It's spooky cool. Yes. I just love it. Having the castle here, having the treehouse. We have a tickle trunk here. And so many memories. There's a wonderful wall where you can, it's a timeline, and you see photographs and you can read about what shows happened in what order. And I was just mesmerized by that.
Amazing.
This is a great museum. I'm so happy to be here. Yeah. And it's free, and it's right downtown Toronto.
Free, again, myseumoftoronto.com. Mark's going to join me again in the next segment. In the meantime, do you mind playing a little song for Nick back in our studio?
Well, I could do the one I started. Hey, dum diddly dum. Hey, dum diddly dum. Hey, dum diddly, hey, dum diddly, hey, dum diddly dum.
Can you believe that The Friendly Giant premiered in 1958? And of course, this is part of what the set looked like. And look who's here, Mark the Repairman from Mr. Dressup,
hey,
playing the theme song.
Here in the castle right now. Yeah, this is great.
How cool is it that you're playing the theme song for The Friendly Giant?
I am trying to.
Let's come on over to the Mr. Dressup section and talk to Mark himself.
I'm coming.
And we, of course, are here at Myseum of Toronto. This is at 401 Richmond Street. It's a free exhibit right through till August 19th. Mark, so nice to see you.
It's so great to be here. Be back at the treehouse with Casey and Finnegan and the tickle trunk over here. And So, Elmer, you snuck up on me.
What was it like to be a part of an iconic show like Mr. Dressup?
It was great. It was just like heaven to show up for the rehearsals. We had a lot of fun. We got a lot of serious work done. But just to be with Dressup and the puppeteers and everybody, the production was just so professional, but so joyous.
Yeah. Do you get a lot of people coming up to you saying, hey, I grew up watching and you were part of my childhood?
I've had that more in the past, but still to this day, some people do recognize me because there's YouTube and I've got a lot of videos of me, a much younger me on Mr. Dressup. And that's kind of neat when I'm at the grocery store. And aren't you a Mr. Dressup? No, I was on Mr. Dressup. I wasn't Mr. Dressup.
Yeah. Many people may not know, but you were a yo-yo champion, and that's pretty much how you sort of got into the world of TV.
That's right. When I was 11, I got the yo-yo bug, and I became Hall City yo-yo champion at 11. But later on, I became the Canadian national champion. And somebody wrote a script for the Mr. Dressup show. They had to have a yo-yo champ. So I got the call and I made sure that the writers and producers, everybody knew that I could play instruments, I could sing songs, I could write original songs. Yeah. I wrote scripts. I was a writer on Mr. Dressup at the end. So
oh,
that was
very cool.
Neat.
We're going to bring in PJ Freshville from YTV, The Zone.
Familiar face.
Here's a fun fact.
Bill!
Mark was a yo-yo champion and made an appearance on The Zone with PJ Freshville. That was cool.
He taught me to throw the yo-yo like this. And catch it like this.
Yeah, you don't do it this way. You gotta throw it that way, get some speed, and then turn your hand over, comes back.
Oh, so nice to see you two together again. This is Myseum of Toronto. Runs through to August 19th. For information, myseumoftoronto.com. It's a free exhibit. Let's say goodbye.
Okay.
And do you mind, Mark, playing this out?
Shout out to Bill Coulter.
Yeah.
I'm a big Bill Coulter fan.
Put your finger in the air, in the air. Put your finger in the air, in the air. Put your finger in the air. Leave it there for about a year. Put your finger in the air, in the air. Wave goodbye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, my friends. Goodbye. From the Myseum. When we part, it makes me want to cry. Oh,
make sure
I can
finger.
Sing louder than Phil.
Nostalgic PJ film, Mr. Dressup, all the good feels this morning.